What's up, guys? Mason Burchett here from Metal Roofing University, powered by Best Buy Metals. Today, I'm going to go over with you how to install a outside closure strip on a tough rib metal roofing panel. Alright, so the product I'm working with today is the Bronze HD Finish Tough Rib Panel. We manufacture this at Best Buy Metals. HD is that textured finish. This is probably my favorite finish to work with. The closure strip we're working with is the LP2 Vented Outside Closure. And you can tell this is an impressive looking product just by seeing it here on the video. This is by Marco Industries. We partner with Marco Industries on several of their products, including this one. They are on the leading edge of metal roofing technology. They are innovators, and we're proud to work with them and carry their products. So the purpose of an outside closure is to close off the gap between your ribs. We've got 9 inches of space in between our tough rib panel here, between each rib. And you need to close this off to prevent access to your attic space. Otherwise, you're going to have bats, wasps, squirrels, and other kinds of bugs trying to nest underneath there. And that can pose some issues. But the catch here is you can use a solid closure strip to close those off, but you're not going to allow your attic space to breathe. So if we want to achieve a breathable attic space, so if you have vented soffit or something like that, then we still need to have that airflow coming out of the attic. That's where the vented closure strip comes into play. Vented closure strips close off that gap, but they still allow airflow to come through. This LP2 closure strip is the exact same width as our tough rib panel, 36 inches wide, and it has the exact same profile as the tough rib ribs do. So this will fit exactly to the panel, even the two minor ribs. This gives us a great seal, okay? On the back of this LP2 closure, we see a strip of wax paper, all right? And this is just protecting, we'll peel this back, this protects a double bead of M83 adhesive. And this is extremely tacky, and this just allows the closure strip to stay in place once you install it. Now, it's important to note that this adhesive does not replace the need for a sealant, okay? So we still recommend using a sealant. You can use your favorite tube sealant. We use MPC 900 at Best Buy Metals, or you can use a strip of butyl tape, which is personally my favorite, and that's what I'm going to demonstrate for you today. So this is just a 45-foot roll of 3/8-inch butyl tape. This is like a mastic material, and I like butyl tape better than I like tube sealant. I just feel like it lasts longer, and it's a lot easier to work with. Now, a good question here is how far down the panel should you install the closure strip? Well, right here, I've got a screw line, so I'm going to install it right above that for demonstration purposes. But, you know, your typical metal roofing ridge cap is usually 12 inches wide, and that's going to give you around 5 inches of play on both sides of the ridge, depending how wide your ridge gap is. So keep that in mind, and there are wider ridge caps. We also stock a 16-inch at Best Buy Metals, and you can get them even up to 24 inches or wider. So it depends on how wide your ridge cap is, exactly where you'll place the closure strip. What you want to aim for is to have the nail strip of the ridge cap be right on top of the closure strip so that it is a seamless fit and you don't have the closure strip poking out from underneath the ridge cap. That you want to avoid that. So you want it to be nice and flush right here along this nail flange on your ridge cap. All right, so now we're ready to install the LP2 closure strip onto our tough rib panel. I'm going to remove this wax paper and expose this double bead of M83 adhesive. And then I'm going to install my butyl tape on the closure strip. So I already have a pre-cut piece of 3/8-inch butyl tape, and I always recommend just applying this butyl tape onto the closure strip and not try to put it on the roof first. That's very difficult to line up. Okay, so I've got my closure strip laid out here, and I'm just going to apply this 3/8-inch run of butyl tape right in between this double bead of adhesive and make sure that it's conforming really good to these rib notches. And then once I've got this completely installed, I'm going to just go ahead and remove the wax paper off of this butyl tape. And that way it'll be ready just to stick directly to the panel. All right, so we can see I've got the butyl tape here. And this is a little sloppy, but it'll work. So I'm going to go ahead and just put this directly on top of the tough rib panel. And then I'm just going to apply some firm pressure to the top of this closure and make sure we get a good seal here against the tough rib panel. Don't want any leaking going on, so we'll press that nice and firm, just like that. And you can see up top here how good of a seal that this closure strip has made against the tough rib panel. Nice and tight, it's conformed to those ribs perfectly, and we're not going to have any issues with insects or moisture getting underneath this closure strip. Okay, our closure strip is installed, and now we're just going to place our ridge cap directly over top of that here. And again, I've got a smaller piece just for display purposes, but it would sit just like this on the roof, and then you're going to attach your metal roof fasteners right here through every rib and into the roof deck. And that's going to make sure, of course, that your ridge cap doesn't fly off, which is very important. All right, now you have a vented ridge. You're not going to have any bats, bugs, or insects crawling underneath your ridge cap and getting into your attic space, and you're going to have a properly ventilated attic space that is free from moisture with this LP2 closure strip. If you guys want to purchase the LP2 closure strip, you can go to bestbuymetals.com, hover over the tool store, click on accessories, scroll down just a little bit, and you'll see it right there in the tool store. You can click on that, click add to cart or buy it now, and we will ship this directly to you. I'm going to put a link to this page in the description, so you can just click on that and go directly to this page. Thanks for tuning in, guys. We'll see you next time on Metal Roofing University, powered by Best Buy Metals.